I was like, yeah. It's
okay. Recording now.
It's
all right. Yeah, it was awesome. Sweet, we're recording?
Yes, cool. We are recording.
Oh!
The show is nice. Starting, I guess.
Yo, Dante, get your butt in here.
I gotta figure out the thing to link the thing from the YouTube.
Oh, it's a baby donkey and two pink casts. That's adorable. Look at it. It broke its legs. Yes. Now I gotta move. God, why you gotta make everything complicated?
America, that's why.
America.
Yeah, America.
America. Okay, nuclear proliferations. Get afuera.
Oh, get closer to us.
Afuera.
Yes,
we
have to
yes, yes. Can you see both of us? Yes, you can. Look at those sexy
you
beasts.
Can see
yes.
These sexy beasts over here.
Yes.
And Striker.
Yes. Wait, are we broadcasting?
Yeah, we are recording.
We are live.
We're live. We are live recording. And
all right, you so want me to do the intro?
Yes, let's do the intro.
Do the intro, right, my
I'll
friend.
I'll do it. You ready? Be quiet.
All right.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the very first broadcast of Claws and Convo. I am your motorcycle riding, pipe smoking, leather jacket wearing, foxy host, Dante Padfoot.
You can go for next.
And I'm your sexy co-host, Hanske.
I am your badass feline host, Striker Cheeguire.
China.
I'm China Rose, the girl. There you go. Done.
The girl. All right. Liam.
And the one who slipped in dog pee. Let's hear it.
I am Liam Wolf, the competition shooter.
So wait, okay. We'll start off. We have to get this established. Tell the story of how can't...
Liam Wolf over there slipped and pee.
All right, so Liam Wolf, here's the deal. He walked out of his room in the middle of the night to go get something to drink.
It wasn't the middle of the night.
The middle of the morning. The middle of the morning, whatever. Needless to say, it was dark out. And this moron didn't have the balls and brains to turn on a light switch. So he's walking down the hall, and out of nowhere, there's a pool of wet. And he slips and realizes it's dog pee. Needless to say, he tore a ligament in his knee on dog pee.
Now we know him. We're not 100% sure what's wrong.
On dog pee.
Dog pee.
So from this point on, we will always refer to Liam as the guy who tripped on dog pee.
We will never let him live it down.
Never.
I'll be making sure to kill you when I'm on
He offered to give Hanske $3 to
no,
stop.
No, only $2.
$2.
What a cheap ass. Come on, man.
Come on.
Come on, man.
You want
mean,
me
you
to
know,
give
at
you
least,
three
like, offer me some, like, Nutter Butters
you
or
want
something,
fine,
bro.
I'll buy you Nutter Butters.
I'm not going to stop, but I want... Yeah, I need about Tree Fitty.
You need about Tree Fitty.
You need about Tree Fitty.
At the end of the show, when we do our storytelling segment, we have to tell
we
that
have
story.
To tell the Tree
it's
going to
be a dual thing, okay?
Yeah.
We'll each tell little parts of the story.
But we need to make sure they understand the reference.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, all right, okay. Anyway, what's next? What's next?
What do we want to talk about?
I don't know. What do we want to talk about, Donske? Dante? I mixed your name and my name, Donske. If our characters were gay and had a baby, it'd be Donske.
By the way, we're straight. Thought I'd establish that.
Yes, ladies, we're single.
Sorry.
Yes.
And desperate.
And Rachel face palms.
You know what, Kenny? You tripped on dog pee, man.
Nothing okay, here. China and Liam have to share this microphone. So yeah, you got something to say, say it in the microphone, okay?
We are
so unorganized.
That's all
I got to throw out
Don't
there.
Be a impossible. Piece of garbage.
Don't be a sandbagging son of a bitch. Just throwing
so,
it out there.
Okay, I got something that I saw on Facebook today that I should probably mention. And I don't know if it's actually serious or not, but I was on Facebook today. And I'm sure that everyone, if anyone's watching this, like, you've probably seen Furcast, you know. Paradox the Wolf is the host of Furcast, posted on Facebook today that he's really mad, and then he said that Friday Night Tech and Furcast might get canceled. And so far, I don't have any details, but that's all I know. And I really don't... Are you...
You are a jerk!
This is a serious thing!
I didn't know nothing, man!
This is a serious thing, man.
You know,
Furcast might get canceled.
I'm sorry. That's too bad,
yeah,
man. Like,
sensitive.
I feel for you, bros, but
You haven't even seen Furcast.
I haven't seen Furcast.
You don't know the epicness.
It's the inspiration for all of this right now.
I'm sorry. Yeah. I understand. It's a sad day when things get canceled, but
well,
I like the light and the mood. I mean,
speak into the microphone, fool.
This is not a time.
You can hear me.
You're doing a horrible job.
I'm holding it. However I want to.
Yeah. I'll eat it if I want to.
Why not?
It looks like chocolate cake as it is.
It looks like a giant chocolate cupcake. It's glorious. Well, it kind of looks like something else too. But
oh, so you enjoy eating those too?
He enjoys it very much, apparently.
Oh, you tripped on dog pee. You tripped on dog pee.
It's not gonna work forever.
You tripped on dog pee.
How in the hell does that happen? How in the hell?
Oh, Liam, show them your cup. Show them your cup.
We should show them our pipes.
Yes. Look at that. Giant freaking thing.
Now that would make him a badass if he hadn't already tripped on dog pee.
Yep. That's exactly right.
Yep. The dog pee.
You know what does make people badasses?
Not tripping on dog pee?
Not smoking?
These pipes.
Smoking pipes.
Yes. See, like, we just got these today.
You guys are terrible experiences for children. You know that, right?
I feel like we're being a bad influence.
You are being a bad influence. You're being a horrible influence.
Okay, kitties, don't smoke.
Don't smoke, kids. It's bad.
Only cats can't smoke.
We're bear. Like, bear, fox,
okay.
Thing. I don't know.
Yes. Hanska over here is a bear. Do you want to tell him a little bit about your fursona or something?
Cool. Okay, so my fursona is a Native American Sioux Indian bear who travels and is awesome. His name is Hanska Amani, which is kind of a unique name. It means tall wanderer in Sioux Indian speak. So, there's my story,
because
and I'm sticking to it.
Because you have Sioux Indian blood.
Because I have Sioux Indian blood.
Isn't that the coolest thing ever?
My great-great-grandfather traded two white horses for my great-great-grandmother. Now, wouldn't it be nice if it was still that easy?
Oh, man. There wouldn't be any forever alone people in the world anymore.
No.
There'd be a lot of horses.
You know what? Why don't the forever alone girls and the forever alone boys join up?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
Maybe it's because forever alone people, maybe the reason they're forever alone is because they have such high standards.
Because they watch too much porn.
Because they watch too much porn.
They're waiting for that porn star
to come around and just go down on them, and it's not going to happen that way.
Nope.
So maybe people need to, you know, lower their standards a little bit.
I would agree.
Be happy with what they get.
I would completely agree. China, you want to talk about your fursona?
Okay,
just a wee bit.
I don't want to.
It's cool, okay?
Okay.
These cups are cool. That's what's cool.
This is cool.
No, you tripped on dog pee.
You tripped
on
dog pee. It's not cool.
Go to hell.
Yeah.
You destroyed it with your all slippage.
Yeah.
Avon Helgerson texted
you.
Want
me to show him the brace?
Maybe. Dude, we should get together with them and play Munchkin tonight.
That's a good idea.
He has the servers down.
What did he say?
He has the servers down. I feel like I'm breaking rules here.
Yeah, tell him that we're in the middle of something. I'm sorry.
All right. Okay. I'm just texting him. Yeah.
China.
Okay.
Da-da-da-da.
I guess I'll tell you my persona and stuff. So, I am a panda bear.
Da-da-da.
Shut the fuck up.
Da-da-da-da-da-da.
You sandbagging zombie.
Tell your story. I'm giving you background music.
I guess I get epic background music. Okay, so I am a panda. And I don't... My name's China Rose, mostly because, like, that's what my grandma wanted to name me when I was born. Then my mom looked at her and said, that was a Russian prostitute's name. And I was like, and then when my grandma told me, I was like, God, I wish I had that name. Like, I would love to be a Russian prostitute. I'd be like, hey, I'm about to treat 50.
So, okay, not only is she a panda bear, she's from China. She's black, white, Chinese, and Russian, and a prostitute.
And a prostitute, I
if
guess.
If that isn't multiracial, I don't know what is.
Most smartly racial... piece of shit ever.
Oh, brother. So,
the only more racist than that is that she was a Taiwanese whore.
Liam Wolf, would you like to tell us about your fursona a bit?
Oh, why not? So,
his fursona trips in dog pee.
Shut up!
Just let him talk.
So, mine is, of course, a pure white wolf in military camo because I'm a huge supporter of the military and my goal is to join the military. So, I thought, right now, since I can't join, why don't I just create a character that persones me in the military, and I can also live it in my dreams that I'm in doing military. So
that's a nice idea. Like, I mean, I've always liked military personas. Like, especially, have you seen like much furry or
yeah?
What is the word I'm looking for? Military furry artwork. It's like, it's great because it's so cool. Like, in fact, I used to have one just a while ago on my background on my PC.
It was beautiful. You still do?
No, no, it's like different one. The one I have now is more of like a freedom fighter thing. Mm-hmm. It's like a, I don't know, a fugitive. So we went through all of us. Wait, I haven't talked about my persona much.
You haven't talked. I haven't talked about mine yet either.
You want to go first?
Go for it.
Go for it.
My persona is a jaguar. It's a hybrid of a king cheetah jaguar with a little touch of lynx in there for the fluffiness.
Yeah, that's creative. That's cool.
Indeed. Indubitably.
So you want to hear the most uncreative persona in the world?
What is it?
A fox.
Oh!
Guess who's a fox?
You?
Me!
Really? I never would have guessed.
So my name's Dante Padfoot. Dante is based off of a, 14th century Italian poet?
Some really old Italian poet guy.
The guy that wrote the original Divine Comedy, which most people know as Dante's Inferno, the original epic poem. Basically, I modeled my persona after him because he is very similar to me, just the way he fits into society. Like, he was a lot smaller than all of his friends that went to war and stuff like that. He was the guy that stayed home and wrote poems. And that's a little bit like me. And Padfoot is just my favorite character in Harry Potter. So there. Pretty basic.
Yeah.
But I also have a little...
We have to have a fox on the show, otherwise it's impossible.
Yeah, because it's not a furry if there's not a fox. And it's, you know...
To ruin everything.
Yeah.
Naturally.
But basically, I mean, you know, I just have these little... The only thing different about mine is I have, like, anime-style haircut. I'm the only one... Me and Chico are Striker are the only ones that actually have our fursonas drawn out.
Wait, I have my fursona drawn out. You guys do, jerk.
Too. You guys do, too.
I drew mine.
I forgot about it.
My drawing just sucks.
But anyway, I've drawn mine a couple times. So it looks really nice, but I still haven't gotten a commission.
We need to get commissions.
Because these guys need to go to a convention with me sometime.
Yo, any of y'all who are watching this who want to do some commissions for us, man? Like,
for free.
Hit us up. Because we are poor college students.
Poor ass college students.
Who are not artists by any means.
Kenny?
But, yeah. Anyway.
I have a bum leg. Give me a break.
You're over there. Closer to it, though.
I have a bum leg.
The coffee pot's up there.
Oh. Yo, Ken. Oh, Ken,
just go grab it.
Liam, will you go get me a dooski?
No.
Why not?
Oh, I thought you still had
to. Because you slipped in pee? Are you still bitter about it?
He's scared to go outside so because he doesn't want to slip on pee.
Oh, goodness.
All right, what now, my friends? What now?
Kind of wish you would fall on pee.
Why do you want me to fall on pee?
Then we can have something to make fun of you for.
People have things to make fun of me for all the time.
But not as
he likes eating, you know, hoes.
I love eating. I like
that. It looks like cupcakes.
Oh, you're a jerk.
Shut up.
You slipped on pee, man, okay?
At once.
Okay, if he would have just slipped on pee and nothing would have happened to him, fine. He slipped on knee and threw out his leg. I mean...
That is ridiculous. I'm
come on.
Lie.
Like, that's noteworthy to make fun of.
Here's the worst part, too. So, what happened was we decided we needed to, you know... take some of our puppies to a shelter, you know, so they can have a new home. Well, we were sad that we got rid of them, so we decided to bring them back. The one we brought back was the one that hadn't been potty trained very well.
Critical error.
Very critical, but it may have happened, but let me tell you, I'm happy I have my dogs. They are my world. I love dogs, and that's why I also picked a wolf, because dogs are my favorite animal. I'm willing to sacrifice a leg.
He used to be an adventurer too, but then he took
some urine to the knee.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, Skyrim things.
Skyrim things. An arrow to the knee thing.
Okay, since we're doing jokes, I might as well just go with the one that I told you about a couple days ago.
Oh yeah, go for it.
So I was watching YouTube, and the Squirtle reference came up, and I just thought it was funny as heck. And this is a pickup line that you use. So you walk up and you ask, "Can I Squirtle on your Jigglypuff?"
Uh-huh. He literally calls me in the middle of whatever I was doing. I think I was just playing. I was like messing around on Skyrim with my friends, and then Kenny calls me and tells me about it. It was that good. He loved it that much that he just had to call me about it.
It's kind of clever.
We love you, Liam Wolf. We do.
You can all go to hell.
That's a little bit harsh for us telling you we love you.
Here's the thing, though. In hell, it's so hot the pee evaporates, so there's nothing to slip on.
Thank you.
So, like how pee evaporates, the story just needs to evaporate and go the fuck away.
Good luck with that one, man.
It doesn't work out that way. So I should probably mention that these guys here, they're not huge on, like, they just joined the furry fandom, basically. Like, they just made fursonas. Me and Striker have been in it for a while. We've gone to fur meets, et cetera, et cetera. But if it seems like these guys don't know what they're talking about, it's because they don't.
We don't.
I kind of
think. They do a little bit, because they go on to, like, you know, I showed you guys a lot of stuff, and you listen to me talk.
Yeah.
You listen to me ramble on about furry stuff, you know.
Yeah.
So you kind of get it.
I do things to embarrass you for fun.
Yes. Yeah. When has that never happened?
All the time.
Yeah.
But so these guys basically wouldn't be here if it wasn't for me. And when it came to
All right.
Yeah.
Let's give you a pat on the back. My goodness.
Thank you.
Egotistical bastard.
Hey, come on. You're the guy that...
Yeah, look who's talking. Look who's talking.
You have no room to talk.
That's cute.
Oh, it's a baby.
It's the most egotistical.
I wish we could show you what we're looking at right now, because there's a cute little baby. What is that? Jaguar? What is that? It's cute as hell.
Show it to
It's a cute puma cub. Oh, no. Come back.
Just go back.
Where'd it go?
Go back.
I'm drying. There it is. It's a puma cub.
Show it to Striker.
Oh, it's adorable.
Cute as hell.
The kind of thing we would see on Pinterest if we had a Pinterest account.
Well, we do.
I don't.
I have a Pinterest account.
What the hell is this thing?
China.
Get with the times, bro.
Guess what account I made last night?
What?
Tumblr.
Did you make a Tumblr?
I made a Tumblr account.
Really?
Finally.
Really?
What did you say?
Nothing.
Oh, gross.
What did he say?
Nothing. I didn't say nothing.
You know Tumblr has lots and lots of
porn. We'll just go back to the video and we'll listen.
Yes, it does.
I made a porn.
It has a lot of furry stuff.
Did you just say you made a porn?
I made a porn comment.
I thought you said you made a porn.
I didn't even hear what you said.
I said, you said, guess what site I got an account to?
And I said, you got an account to Bang Bros?
You're so
Mason,
funny.
Hey, how do you know about that site anyways?
You told me about it. You and your Alexis Texas fetish.
What the heck is an Alexis Texas fetish?
She's like a porn star, I guess. I don't know. Oh, right? Okay. Is that right?
Because that didn't sound like
right?
It sounded like a really, really dirty fetish.
Well, it kind of is. I mean, she's a porn star.
Well, no, I mean, like, she's gross. Like some of the stuff that China was telling me that one night, like the names for, like, what was it? What was some of the stuff you were telling me about?
Wait, what?
We don't need to talk about it. On the, like, just
like
say.
The Alaskan pipeline.
Oh, yeah, you told me about that.
That is not pleasant.
Children, this is not for you.
Not for children. Log out.
Parental guidance is advised.
Not 18.
Parental
log
out. Suicide.
Well, I mean, if you're like 16, whatevs. But
16,
like,
I mean, you already know.
Yeah, you're getting there.
If you ride a school bus about the age of seven,
you
know. If you
do, like, junior high, you kind of know, but, like, yeah.
I knew about this stuff when I was
16.
Don't repeat this. Don't repeat what we're saying.
No, are you going to tell them what it is?
I'm not going to tell them what it is.
Never tell them what it is.
Sheltered children.
Because you know there.
No, don't look it up. YouTube. Don't look it up.
Or Google. For that.
Well, they found this show, so they're bound to find it eventually.
That's yeah, but true. Anyways, okay, the whole point I'm trying to make is that she was just telling me about this stuff last night, some of these really, really nasty stuff, and it wasn't very pleasant. Yeah. What kind of person does that?
What kind of person does an Alaskan pipeline? That's disgusting.
Any of this stuff. What kind of sick human being does that?
I don't know.
Liam, shut the door.
Dutch oven things.
Shut the door. It reminds me of a newscast that was on... A while ago.
Your face reminds me of a newscast.
Let's just say it had to do with a table, and it was bad.
So do we want to do a 20-minute banter and then go into the...
Kids, stop hitting.
Yeah.
Children.
Do that.
Make him stop.
Stop.
He's bigger than I am.
Don't tell me what to do.
Okay, do we want to do a 20-minute banter segment and then go into the news?
What are we going to banter about?
This is banter.
Oh, this is banter.
Yes.
You're my cable's messed up.
I'm sorry. Yes, we can do a 20-minute banter segment.
Because we got another minute before we have to go.
Yeah, okay, minute banter time. What should we complain about? Let's complain about...
Well, okay.
How long that thing was.
Let's complain about the fact that you can't have a beard at work. How does that make you feel?
Well, it doesn't make me feel very good, Bob.
Why are you calling me Bob?
Because that's the good response to you is when somebody says something like that. Right, okay. When they say, how do you make you feel, you always say Bob all afterwards.
Right. Fair enough. Yeah, I feel like that's prejudice against real men.
Named Bob.
I feel like Hy-Vee just wants women to work for them.
Exactly.
And not men. Because what's the harm of having a beard when you're handling vacuum-sealed food and things like that the hair can't even get into? And if it's a well-groomed beard like it should be, you're not going to shed.
They should just say, like, if your beard gets, like, Gandalf long.
Yeah, you know? Well, but if it's Gandalf long, you're a wizard. You can do whatever you want.
You can still braid it, though.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, you can,
braid it.
Like Gimli.
Like a boss.
Like a Gimli beard. Yeah. We're talking about Lord of the Rings now. We're giant nerds.
Anyways.
You know what we did today? We spent time in a comic book shop.
Oh, yes.
You know what I did today?
What did you do today?
I emptied a truck.
Very nice.
That sounds like fun.
And then I smoked for about an
hour. We went to Riverside and ate food, and tonight we should go get pie and some coffee.
That sounds
celebration is our first. Celebration.
I have to go back to work.
You have to go to work? Sucks to be you. Hey. Don't trip on any dog pee while you're there, my friend.
How can I when there's no dogs in the call?
Well, don't trip on any drunk dorm student pee, my friend. That would be even worse.
That kind of disturbed me that drunk dorm students are peeing on the floor.
Well, you know, I mean, crazier things happen.
Have you ever smelled the elevator? Like,
have you ever been into any of the dorms here? They all smell like pee and weed.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like all pee and weed.
I'm okay with it smelling like weed, but not pee. Like,
yeah.
Well, I mean, exactly. If they share, I'm okay with the weed thing. But
they don't share because
they
don't.
They don't share.
Actually,
they don't share. They keep it all themselves.
What?
Yes.
She's not saying anything. Pay no attention to the panda behind the curtain.
So what?
How? Okay, anyway.
Anywho.
All right, should we talk about news now?
Yes, we should.
All right, well,
do you have any articles you want to talk about?
I do want to talk about an article that's very, very interesting.
FYI, in the future we'll have like awesome news music or whatever, but this is kind of something we jumped into.
Organized chaos.
Yeah, Organized Chaos is the name for this first episode.
Care about dancing swans.
So basically we're just going to do whatever. We'll kind of stick to a schedule, but it won't be perfect. Animal news.
Nobody cares.
I want that news that I found. Well, okay, all right.
Just type read it. Yeah, that concerns us. Okay. Just start Kenny you look for stuff, Liam.
1 second.
Like I said, 11-year-old boy found
anyways,
a best preserved
epic
boy
news thing. Music. Dun, dun, dun. Just pretend there's music, news music going on in the background. In the future, we'll have better stuff, but right now, we're just whatevs. Whatevs, man. What are you looking
just
up?
Just got your post on Facebook.
I want to find that
we'll go,
that
go back onto
one.
Go back onto Animal Planet news.
Well, I did, and I can't find it.
Well, it was on the first thing.
Well, I know.
You
sure?
On it. Does anyone else got anything while he's looking for
it? You're already on it?
I'm looking.
Oh, you have poop face?
Well, we got the prison cat smuggling drugs.
My smartphone is smarter than an iPhone.
Well, okay, the...
Okay, shh. Let's hear this article.
Need to hold it?
Yes.
Okay, whatevs. Okay.
Inside Animal Planet.
It's like... Sneaky cat. A cat with a suspicious bag taped around or strapped around to the middle was captured by authorities in Brazil. Inside the bag... They found a cell phone battery, saw blades, parts of a concrete drilling. Cat was caught on New Year's Eve at the prison. Officials suspect prisoners were training the animal to deliver tools to help him get away.
Like, really?
Yeah. Trained a cat to help him break out.
Furcast covered the success story last week.
Did they?
Oh, they
yes.
did.
Furcast.
As you can tell, we get all our news from Furcast.
The same place that Furcast gets them.
Sorry, Furcast. Love you.
Love you.
I just don't watch it as much anymore. I used to be a big fan of it. I met the guys at Midwest Furcast 2011.
Yeah,
they're really nice. I love talking to them.
I
got their autograph.
Yay!
Yay!
So much flutter.
Yeah. I just want to clarify. Yes, we do like My Little Pony, but are we bronies?
No. It's a good show.
No, but it's a good thing Rachel isn't actually in the camera because she's nodding her head yes, and it's not true. I'm not a brony. I just enjoy it. It's so colorful and happy. How can you so not enjoy my little pony?
To help, I am a Pegasister.
Like, yeah.
I'm just going to... I am a Pegasister.
She has a brother who's like straight up brony, like all the way.
He's 26 years old and watching...
Where the hell ponies. Is that first page?
So I do okay not have that. Cable.
Hmm. There's interwebs for that.
Yeah, just get it on Netflix. Like,
I'm lazy.
There's YouTube. You don't have Netflix?
No.
Oh.
There's YouTube machines. That's a shame. That's how I watched it.
Yeah, you can watch it on Netflix. I mean, YouTube. There we go. That's how I first started watching it. I remember. Okay, I'll tell you a quick story.
It's real cute. Okay, it's a palate cleanser.
Okay. I'm gonna tell the quick story of the first time I started watching it. Okay, so. Everyone on the internet was talking about My Little Pony. I'm just like, why would I be interested in this, you know? And everyone keeps saying, I mean, remember, this was the days when it was still a little girl show. You know, nowadays it's looked at differently. But
it
back
still
then,
is a little girl show.
Well, yeah, but
now,
to an extent.
They do, like, meme stuff.
Yeah, so, like, anyway, back in the day, a few years ago, back in the day,
couple days.
Everyone on the internet was talking about it. I was like, okay, I gotta check this out. So I went onto YouTube and watched an episode. I was like, oh, it's not bad. So I watched the next one because it was the first one. I watched the first one and it was a continuation. So I had to see the next one.
Let me read it.
At that point, my brother comes in who already hates the furry thing. Like he just hates this kind of stuff. He hates nerdy stuff. And he walks in and he's like, is that what I think it is? I was like, no. And he said, I promise not to tell anybody about this.
I
said, I don't believe you, because he does that kind of stuff. Anyways, the whole point I'm trying to make is, back in the day, it was worse than somebody catching you watching porn. Like, okay, say your mother walks in, and you're watching My Little Pony, and you quickly switch to a porn tab.
I found something about pandas.
Well, you did?
He found something about pandas.
You found something? Okay.
You want to read it?
Nope.
Hanske's still looking for that story about...
Damn, it's a really cool story.
I found it. Okay.
It's about people.
Okay, all right, okay.
Shh.
All right, so here's the deal. There was a... Wait, what am I...
Fix your cable.
What do I do?
Use my microphone until then.
Striker
and I fix it.
Okay, all right, switch me.
Switch.
Ah.
Ah.
Okay, all right, cool. All right, cool beans. So... Cool news story. A never-before-seen whale washed up on the New Zealand shore. So, a species of beaked whale known previously only from bone fragments has been seen for the first time after a mother and calf recently washed up on a New Zealand shoreline. Called the spade-toothed beak whale, the species has understandably been hailed as the world's rarest whale. While it's unfortunate that the first sighting of the whale comes with such a tragic scene, scientists are thrilled at the chance to learn more about this mysterious species. Until this stranding, it was unclear that the species even still existed. Should I keep reading it? Do you want me to keep reading it?
Depends on how long it is.
Well, it's not super long, but there's a few more paragraphs.
Hold on, I gotta check the microphone. Yeah, it's my microphone's working, so I'll just use this one.
Just right. Don't move it too much.
Yeah, don't move it too much.
Okay.
Mason moves too much.
Shut up.
I'll just hold.
Hold it
exactly.
So,
right
okay,
there,
here, let's retwist him. Okay.
Don't. Why are you guys crossing?
They gotta ports? Play with their minds.
Don't cross the stream.
Don't cross the streams. That's exactly what I was thinking.
Exactly.
I like how you guys
anyway. Minds think alike.
Yeah. Anyway, cool new deal. New whale found. That's pretty sweet.
That is really cool,
actually.
That's
really cool. That doesn't happen very much anymore.
It reminds me of that story that happened like 5 years ago when some strange creature washed up on shore and somebody got like a little, like a really bad picture of it. Does anybody remember that?
Yeah,
I do not.
Cloverfield
vaguely.
Came out.
Yeah,
it
yeah.
It was right when, because everyone's like, oh, it's Cloverfield's monster. And we're like,
it didn't look like
no.
It, though. It didn't look at all like it.
Did you ever hear about the island in Indonesia that like is covered by fog and you can only get to it by helicopter? And there's a cat there that lays eggs?
No.
Like, no joke. Like, well,
no
it's
way.
Not legitimately a feline. Like, it's not part of the feline species, but it looks like a cat.
And it
and
lays,
it lays
eggs.
Eggs.
I've never heard that.
Yeah, it was like a big deal back in the day. And I can't, I haven't heard anything about it yet, but I mean, I remember hearing about it.
That's insane.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. Wouldn't that be crazy? I mean, what would you do if you were just walking around and all of a sudden you see a cat, you know, it looks like he's squatting to take a poop, and out comes a freaking egg. I mean, what was your, I'd probably cry a little bit.
I would too.
It'd be a little weird.
Just walk up, oh, it's a cake. Oh, it's laying eggs!
Weird stuff, man.
Kill him with fire.
There's some
killing with fire. I would
take that egg and bring it home.
Yeah, yeah. Spread the species around.
I would bring it home and I would.
I mean,
we must do science with this.
Would you? How? What would you do? Would you sit on it until it hatched?
I would. I'd put in an incubator. Like, yeah, yeah. Because we live in Southern Iowa.
Well, yeah. I mean,
we all have stuff like that.
Yeah, that's yeah. true. That's
so
true.
We could put it in there, let it but, grow, okay, right, and then but, if it gets all weird, but, I mean, kill it.
But you don't know its diet. You don't know its habitat. So how would you make it survive? I mean, you'd have to, in order to make this work, you'd have to study it in its natural habitat first.
Well, yeah, first.
First. So, I mean, you couldn't just find a cat that lays an egg and take the frick egg.
No,
I mean,
duh.
Yeah.
You have to find out, you know.
Does it okay? Does it lay multiple eggs or just one?
I think it was just one, but I'm not entirely sure. Don't trip on any pee while you're out there, buddy.
you're real mean.
We'll never let him hear the end of it.
I mean, that's a cool thing.
It is a really cool thing. I don't know why I've never heard of that.
It's because you're not as cool as me.
I'm sorry.
Come on.
That's not why, because he has a life and is not always on the interweb.
You know what? Yeah. I'm not always on the interweb.
Look, see, look.
Is this? Wait, we got to scroll up. Oh, whoa, that's cool. Okay, if you can't see it, it's just like a bunch of panda people in panda suits dancing in the street of, where is it? Tai Chi.
They're doing Tai Chi.
Oh, they're doing Tai Chi.
There's no city called Tai Chi.
Okay.
Do you know why?
I'm sorry.
Do you know why, though, they're like that? Do you know? Because they're trying to get pandas to mate.
Really?
They're trying to bring the panda species.
So wait.
So they're doing it with...
So wait. So people are dressing up like pandas...
Yeah.
And dancing
doing
around.
Tai Chi.
Yeah.
Hoping to get a panda to mate.
Yeah.
So are they hoping that the panda's going to think they're a real panda and rape them? Or.
No,
we could make a human panda hybrid. Isn't that what we all want?
That's like Man Bear Pig. You don't want any of that.
Man Bear Pig.
Man Bear Pig.
I'm
cereal.
This has to be a furry topic. Now,
yeah, it is a furry topic.
Is it like a dream of people to see animal human hybrids? Because, I mean, to an extent, I think it'd be cool. But some animals and humans just shouldn't mix. I mean,
yeah.
Like
you're making China feel bad now because you're basically saying that China should not... No. Pandas should not be mixed with humans.
Well, no.
But other animals should.
I'm not saying that. Like, pandas are one of the animals I think should. I think it'd be sweet.
Yeah.
But, like, you know, I don't want to see a half cockroach, half human. Like,
well,
I'd probably kill myself.
If a cockroach and a human could mate physically, that would be fantastic to watch. Like,
what?
Because, like, if that could... Yeah, exactly. Like...
Kill me.
Tiny, bitty cockroach. And then big-ass human. Like, how in the hell? Like... would that shit go down?
I wouldn't want to watch that. That'd be awkward.
In a scientific sense,
it's called bestiality, and it's still gross.
Right.
I'm talking like if we could make like a human animal hybrid, the first one would have to have been artificially made.
Oh yeah,
but
yeah.
It's physically impossible.
You know, I mean, what? I mean, if it comes out in the news, hey, this guy fucked a horse, and now there's a centaur out
there.
Which obviously isn't going to happen because of the genes.
It doesn't work. People are going to be freaking out. And it was like, hey, we mixed the genes of a human and the genes of a horse, and out popped a centaur, and we did this all in a lab. People are like, well, that's pretty darn cool.
I would say that's pretty darn cool.
Science!
I
mean,
but it can't happen, though. Let me debunk it for a second.
Nothing is impossible, China.
That's true.
It can't happen yet. It can't happen yet. I wonder if there's a group of furry scientists who are out there trying to make this work.
Do you want me to tell you why it wouldn't work?
I understand why it wouldn't work.
Okay.
I think we all understand.
Because every furry is like wondered that's about this right. at least
yeah.
once.
Like,
so
I understand.
I think we all understand a little bit. They're but trying. Hey, you want to hear something really cool?
Yes.
There's actually, have you heard of this? There's a company, I don't remember where they are. They're like in Germany or something, and they will surgically make you look like an animal.
Wait,
that's
what?
Awesome.
I'm not even kidding you.
That's what?
That's crazy.
They did that on Furcast like 2 years ago. Like, I mean, it's kind of old news now. I'm sure everyone watching this has probably heard of it. You know, correct me if I'm wrong because it's been forever, but there's legitimately a company out there that is willing to do that. If you have the money.
So what, like plastic surgery to like give you cat ears
yeah,
and stuff?
Yeah,
really?
I'm serious.
Have you not seen Lizard Man?
No, I've seen, well, I guess, yeah.
Lizard Man and the cat girl.
Who was that guy that died recently?
There's a lot of
cat.
Them. I don't.
Catman?
Adam West?
Adam West died?
No!
That's
no,
like Catman.
Fairly Odd Parents reference.
Catman! But he had his face
at the end?
Modified
to who? Like, well, oh yes,
everybody furries. Yes.
Disney turning kids into furries for over 90 years.
Yes, that was really random. We're a random bunch of people. People.
And that's why it's interesting.
We're not interesting.
Random, interesting, but somehow entertaining conversations.
Well, and it helps that you've got two beautiful people up
there. Yeah, yeah.
I mean, look at these faces. I mean, come on.
Yeah, you can't beat this.
I don't understand.
Squeeze in here. Come
no,
on,
no comment.
Look, this is the beautiful faces of Claus and Convo.
Asshole.
There we go.
Yeah, but you love me.
I don't. No, you think I do.
Somebody scream cap this.
I just keep you around. Don't scream.
Yeah.
Someone.
Yeah.
Christmas card.
Someone will scream cap this. And make a gif
sure
out of it.
You do this. Yes. Mason,
yes.
Make a gif out of it.
And once when you do this, make sure that you have a good caption from Mason because he likes having that thing really up close to his
mouth. Yeah, you know, you tripped in pee. Shut up.
Okay, do we want to talk about the... Is it okay, China. China. Is that the news article that you wanted to talk about?
Which one?
The bear panda one? Did you read it or...
I didn't read it.
I kind of have to pee.
Then go pee.
Am I allowed to?
Yes, you can.
I'm going to go pee, everybody. I'll be back.
He announces the shit.
And now the crowd is happy.
Yeah, he's leaving.
Shut up, Liam. You slipped in pee.
Yo, Liam, I'll make sure not to get any on the floor so you don't trip and break your other leg.
You know what? I'll just
get
go.
Get full, gosh.
Get full. Okay. Let's scroll down. Liam, are you looking for
when
new stories?
Back, I'll take his spot.
Take my spot. I'll kill you.
Striker's over there on Facebook. What the heck?
You're not on Facebook?
What the hell?
I'm not on Facebook. I'm looking for news stories. That's what we're supposed to be doing.
I gotta monitor this. Crap.
Don't ask me. Videos playing. Vampire Squid doesn't suck. What?
I don't know. Are we watching this?
I keep getting the same damn game.
What? No, no.
Oh, here we go.
No, no.
Oh, no, no.
No, no, no.
Rare maned lionesses.
I think we already went over that.
This mane.
I think we already went over
like
that.
Like bearded ladies.
She's yes. Like is this? Yeah. Can we hear this microphone?
Now it's working. Yeah.
Okay. Good. 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 Okay. Here's a story about rare maned lionesses, nature's bearded ladies. Can't pronounce that. Botswana's Okavango Delta contains some of the world's most unusual big cats. These lions might look like your typical kings of the jungle, but think again. They're actually queens. Yes, that's right. These rare lionesses sport following golden images just like your male counterparts. While maned lionesses are only a minority among females, in Okavango, they're common enough that safaris in the region often encounter them. Scientists suspected that the appearance could be due to a genetic disposition. If so, there's a good chance that all the maned females are related. A pride full of manes. That's really cool.
That's actually really cool.
That is really cool.
Like, for real? What?
Bearded ladies.
Ladies. Get out of my seat, girl.
Did you hear that, Hanske? There are bearded ladies in Africa.
That's
as in
nice.
maned lionesses.
Yeah.
That's so cool.
I saw that.
Zebra pony runs loose on Staten Island, blah, 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 blah.
I just saw that.
There's the whale one. There's an ad. Oh, chocolate milk!
Don't you touch my chocolate milk.
It's you didn't buy it.
Neither did you.
It's Haley's.
Yeah.
I'm Haley's sister.
Your brother.
Oh, you're
She's
Haley's
my sister. Whoopsie!
Oh, it finally comes out. The truth is revealed.
Shut your face.
Well, that explains everything.
Shut up, you guys.
I'm so proud of you right now.
Oh, let's see.
Like, this is a proud moment in my life for you.
What?
What?
It's okay.
You admitting
Awesome,
things.
We accept you for who you are.
You know what? Get me more coffee, woman.
You're out of coffee, sir.
Wait.
Make
no,
more.
Calling him a sir. He just claimed to be a woman.
Oh, ma'am.
Why are you up?
My
yes.
Hey,
first
lady,
of all.
Lady person, will you get me some
coffee? Por favor.
What am I, your bitch?
Yes.
This
I'm
is a really...
essentially.
Hey. This just proves that cats are still afraid of dogs no matter what.
What?
Okay, you want to read it?
Screw you. Dog herd Siberian tigers.
Nice.
Let's see. What's the story?
It also depends on if the dog is protecting a human, because in that case, it's like a mama bear protecting her cub.
Solo,
yeah, yeah.
A border collie at a South African wildlife reserve has apparently found a sheep herding life, too. So, freaking awesome.
Yeah.
There you go. Now I can hear you.
I feel like everybody that watches FurryCast has seen all these news stories.
Yeah, I feel like that too.
Oh well, screw it.
How do you know anything, Mason?
If you guys want to see the video of the dog doing this, just go to Animal Planet News and you'll find it.
Yeah.
It might take a while to find it though.
Okay, where can we find more?
Now you see what I have to do.
Welcome to Claws and Convo, everybody. This is what we do. Despite what the name says, we have conversations, but we also like to mess around.
We do.
It's fun. Frog has retractable claws like Wolverine.
Freaky.
What? Okay, I gotta read this. The one frog you don't want to meddle with. Just check out the pinchers on this thing. The Japanese Otan frog, Bambina Sup. These always have names that I can't pronounce. Subaspera is one of the only species of frog in the world that possesses retractable claws like a cat. Each of its spines is contained within a sheath and can be pushed out in the front of the digit, but not worth puncturing the skin. Not without puncturing the skin. In other words, the frog has to inflict self-harm to use the spines.
So it's like Wolverine.
Exactly.
Yeah, Wolverine's like always hurts himself.
Yeah. In this way, the frog might be able to apply... might be more aptly compared to the comic book superhero Wolverine.
Oh, hey!
The
cat.
Yeah, well, obviously.
Yeah,
I mean,
obviously, that's in the title.
Yeah,
I
yeah.
thought it meant like the animal Wolverine. Yeah, frickin'
no.
Frickin'
no, 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 no.
Don't call me a schlock.
I do what I want.
You whore.
You whore.
You know, but okay, that explains a lot because I'm pretty sure I've seen... Get your arm off me, lady. Nope. I'm pretty sure that in anime I've seen something like that, like a frog with retractable claws, and I thought it was just the Japanese being Japanese. But I love Japanese. I'm just throwing that out there.
Yes, but we all love Japanese, but they go too far sometimes.
Yes, but now it makes sense. It's something that they actually fear, something they've seen in real life, and they just turn it into an anime thing.
Exactly.
Good for them. Get your arm off me.
You're taking all this space with your legs. Like you're like, I am the man. Must spread my
wings
completely.
You guys are legitimately going to knock the table over. Relax.
Face over.
Remember, he likes opening his mouth wide and spreading his legs wide.
And you like slipping
in
on pee.
So okay, since I'm guessing that we don't really have any emails.
Well, I can check that real quick.
Because I mean, like, Stryker and I recently checked it, and we didn't really expect people. Okay, here's the gist of it. We started, it's our fault because we just started promoting this podcast yesterday. Like, so only a few people know about it. If we were to, like, you know, say put an ad up on Fur Affinity, maybe people would get, like, you know. But for now, we didn't have enough people email us because we didn't promote it enough. Or we didn't have enough time to promote it, basically.
Is that lame?
Oh, you want to read this story?
Sure. Chinese turtle pees through his mouth.
Oh, buddy.
The Chinese soft-shell turtle might be an adorable species, but this is one reptile you wouldn't want to steal a kiss from.
Ho-ho!
Biologists from the National University of Singapore have discovered that these unusual creatures are capable of passing urine through their mouths. According to the BBC, it may not sound very appetizing, but it's a surprising and remarkable adaptation for life in brackish water. Kenny, I feel like I just found the Joker to your Batman.
Oh! Ah! Tisk, tisk.
Aha. Yes. that's a strange thing. Why would you... What is the advantage of peeing through your mouth?
I don't know.
I'm trying to apply Darwin's theory of natural selection and why something like that would be beneficial.
Perhaps it's an alternative. It's way of saying fuck you.
Well, yeah, but I mean, you know, yeah. Here's the deal. If somebody's gonna, let's say there's, I don't know, a barracuda or something that's gonna eat this thing. It's gonna eat the pee no matter what, whether it comes out of the mouth or comes out of the bladder.
Yeah.
So what survival advantage would this give this turtle?
I think it's just to mess with people like us.
You think it's just to
because it's like
to cause people
it's like oh you think you've seen everything? Here's a freaking turtle that pees through its freaking mouth.
Yeah, like you
like
see
that.
It all?
Yeah.
Nope.
I
just kidding.
What if
you
it's
haven't.
Just spinning?
Now I've seen everything.
What if it's just spinning? I mean, maybe it's just spinning.
Maybe they tested it for. Yes. Yeah.
They had to have tested it.
Because I'm guessing they did that.
Okay, all right. Well, maybe it's a toxic urine. Maybe it's like the spinning
like,
cobra.
Or kind of like the frogs, like the poisonous frogs where people would eat them. Not people.
Or like that lizard that shoots blood out of its eyeballs.
That's true.
Yeah. But like, you know, I mean,
Maybe it's a shock and awe thing. I mean, maybe some animal's yes. coming along. Hey, you look tasty, peeing out of your mouth. The hell?
If it has the same properties as like we could, hell? I bet somebody will find a way to get high off of this. You know like that's going
to
happen.
Like okay, look, man. There's a way to get high off of everything. If I want, okay, it's like if you want to, you can get high off of air. You can take little like, air yeah. cans. Like and you know, when cats spray.
And Hanske was like just doing that a few minutes ago.
I was not. I was using territory. Cream. There's a difference.
Yes.
You were trying to get high.
No,
off of it.
I was because it changes your voice. I like how now we have our own conversation going.
Okay. Anyways,
I love whipped cream. I love whipped cream.
You that could be taken the wrong way.
You want to send me something? Send me some whip, some ready no. whip whipped cream.
Okay. Anyways, about the frogs, like it's you know since people will find a way to get high off of this, just like the frogs. Okay, it was a natural defense mechanism that they have where an animal will eat this. You know the frogs that you lick. You know.
Yeah. Why would you lick a frog?
It's a toad.
Toad. There we
why
go.
Do you lick a toad?
Okay. Because they have an acid on their back. Which
yeah,
they
and it
secrete,
makes you hallucinate like.
And
when you
oh, okay, okay. So it's like okay,
acid.
Gotcha. So it makes you high. Got
yeah,
it.
Yeah.
Anyways, so the reason they have that is so that predators will see that toad and they're like, oh yeah, I'm gonna eat you. So they eat it and they walk away. They're like, whoa, dude.
But they
like
still,
that.
But they still ate the toad, so the toad's still dead.
Maybe they didn't swallow it. And the toad is just going to be a cripple for the rest of its life. Maybe he should have just gotten eaten in the first place.
Just like, just all eat right. me now. Like, I'm crippled. Just
I don't know.
Me.
I don't know. Let's move on. Yeah. Let's move on.
Let's move on. We're speculating far too much.
All right. We all need right. a laptop over here. We're huddling around my iPod right now.
Here, Mary.
Lost boy kept warm by his puppies. Aww.
Aww.
I don't think a kitty would do that. I'm just throwing that out there.
Nope.
Oh, gosh. It disappeared.
You have bad luck with stories doing
what?
That.
Shut up. Okay,
all sorry.
Right. So, a 10-year-old boy reported missing overnight earlier this week in Marion County, Alabama, was found in some nearby woods and thick brush, snuggling with two puppies.
Ooh.
Upon initial reports of the missing boy, dozens of volunteers and the Marion County Sheriff's Department researched for the boys all night. Officials said at one point, at least 150 volunteers were searching for the boys. A volunteer searcher said he found his family dog alone in a creek in thick brush and found the dog's puppy with the boy around 9:30 a.m. on Wednesday. Hmm. I heard the dog barking again and followed him down there and started hollering for the puppies, and I hollered for him and he hollered back. He was in the creek about half a mile over the ridge, said searcher Jamie Swinging. Officials said the boy was wet and had no shoes. They think the puppies kept him warm overnight.
Oh,
that's
a heartwarming story.
Adorable. That, my friend.
That's why I like
is
dogs.
Why dogs are superior to kitties.
Yes, they are. Like I've heard so many stories like that, and they're all I believe all of them.
Yeah.
Because dogs do that. Like, yeah. Okay. For the record, my mom is a corgi breeder, so that's pretty awesome right there. First of all,
corgis are adorable.
And like, second of all, we have a lot of corgis that are running around the house all the time. Hanske came over one time.
Oh my gosh, it was like corgi heaven, man.
And they all just ran up to him. It's like a sea of corgis that run up
awesome.
To him.
Awesome.
It was. And I've been living there my entire life. And I mean until just this year when I moved up here, but before that, I was living around the corgis all the time and I never got tired of them. Like
how do you get tired? I mean, how would you get tired of a corgi?
You
I
cannot
mean,
get tired.
They are
oh, thank
the
you, China.
Cutest. Oh wait, that's not mine. Where's this my mine. Spades?
See, she's a good woman.
Good woman.
She's our woman.
Good woman. We
anyways,
should get her a treat.
We
should get her a treat.
What
yes.
do pandas eat?
What do
besides bamboo? Like no, I meant like what kind of treats?
Eucalyptus. Interesting fact about pandas. Actually, I want to share this now.
Okay.
Because it makes pandas not as cute as people think they are. So, pandas generally give birth to twins.
Okay.
But they do not, their mammary glands do not have the capacity to feed both twins and make them both be healthy.
I think I know where this is going.
So, generally speaking, the panda mother has to choose one of the babies to leave behind.
Cows do that too.
Really?
Really, really.
Cows do that?
Cows do it all the time. I had a bottle keep feed a calf once because like his mom wouldn't take him.
Yeah, so there's that.
That's really sad, actually.
When I heard about it, I kind of teared up a little bit.
That's
little,
sad.
Cried a little bit.
Like they have to.
And
the
if
mother
you watch Furry Cast, we watched one about bears yesterday.
Oh yeah, we watched like episode 80 something about
God
bears.
Sends bears to attack children.
There is a story in the Bible. I don't remember where it is.
Yeah, I know what it is. It's Elijah.
Yeah, yeah.
It's Elijah.
So basically. There were kids making fun of him for his bald head.
He shaved his head in a ritualistic way of worshiping God, and they made fun of him. And so you know what Elijah did? He called on 40 she-bears.
No. It was two bears that
was
killed.
It two bears?
It was two,
it was
bears
two
that killed,
she-bears that killed 40 kids.
Yes. That's they killed right. 40 kids.
40.
Yes?
Where's the sugar cubes?
Are you seriously getting sugar for your coffee? You woman.
She's a okay, it's acceptable.
I just drink black coffee like 4 cups.
It's okay. Seriously. It's different if a man has sugar in his coffee. All right, okay. You know, that's just pansy, you know, but it's okay if a woman does it because women generally have sugar in their coffee. So it's okay. Anyways, I have no idea where the sugar cubes are.
Did
that's
they
my
eat
point.
All my sugar cubes like horses?
I don't know. Like horses. I only had one.
Stryker, you look like you got something to say over there.
Oh, I'll drink a black whatever.
I forgot.
Okay. Fair enough.
I feel like...
Oh, yeah, I was going to say, you know, that cheetahs are the greatest mothers ever.
They are.
They will stand up against the lion 3 times their size.
Cheetahs and grizzly
I believe
bears.
That.
If you get between a grizzly bear mom and her cubs, man, you dead.
And foxes just kind of stay in their hole.
Foxes are like, oh, well...
They only come out at night, and they explore cities a lot.
Really?
Like, foxes have been known to... wander around in cities.
Here's a really interesting story.
Ooh, can I read
it? Cougar.
Can I read
it? You can read it.
It's my turn to read a story.
It's your turn to read
a
story.
Okay, here we go.
I got that. That was great.
Man lost at sea for 15 weeks, saved by a shark? What?
Indeed.
Usually, a shark fin circling your boat is the last thing you want to see when you've become lost at sea. But according to one man who has been aimlessly set adrift for 15 weeks... It was a shark, not a dolphin, whale, or seabird, which miraculously beaconed him to safety. Really? Tokai Taitoi, a 41-year-old policeman from the islands of Kiribati, sorry if I pronounced that wrong, became stuck on his 15-foot wooden boat after running out of fuel. He had set off with his brother-in-law from the island of Tarawa in late May on what was supposed to be a 2-hour journey to the nearby island of Maina. The pair had decided to stop and fish along the way and eventually turned it into an overnight trip. By the time they woke the next morning, however, they had become lost and were previously low on fuel. Quote, "We had food, but the problem was we had nothing to drink," explained, Taitoi to Sky News. Dehydration began to take a hold immediately, though the two men were able to survive together for over a month by curling up under the bow of the boat to stay out of the sun. Tragically, on July 4th, Taitoi's brother-in-law succumbed to that dehydration in the morning, still slept with his perished brother-in-law overnight, until granting him a burial at sea the following day. Okay, long story short, this is going too long. What is so funny?
Why are you laughing?
Why are you interrupting my news story?
They're making fun of us.
No, we're not. It was great.
What?
I'm playing words.
Whatever.
Play on words. Good times.
All right.
Okay. I don't even want to know what you're thinking right now. Okay. Taitoi began to notice a curious pattern with the shark that came upon him recently. I skipped a big chunk because I don't want to read the entire thing. It would bump and scratch at the hull of the boat and circle around until it caught his attention. Huh. Then once he emerged to see what it was doing, the shark would swim off almost like a dog trying to become its owner to follow it. What does this remind you of? Lassie! What is it? Is Timmy stuck in the well, Lassie? Yes, it does.
Okay. I agree,
110%. That's legitimately what it's like.
Kind of.
You guys are jerks. He was guiding me to the fishing boat, believed Taitoi. I looked up and there was a stern of a ship, and I could see crew with binoculars looking at me. And over 100 days lost at sea, Taitoi was saved, and he gives a lot of credit to that shark for keeping him alert and hopeful.
Cool.
That is really cool. I didn't know that sharks did that.
See, I don't think it was the shark's intention. I'm just going to throw that out.
Probably.
It just worked out that way.
Lure him into dinner.
Yeah, yeah. Like, he tried to lure him into a big ambush of sharks or something.
He's coming to dinner. Well, this guy is.
He's like, hey, come here. Come here now. What? Come on.
What?
A black lab becomes the first canine archaeologist.
What?
All right. Migaloo is a black Labrador retriever who has become the first certified archaeology dog in Australia. She works with archaeologists hoping to uncover grave sites all over Australia and eventually ancient civilizations all over the world. So why is Migaloo uncovering histories of the world? Simple. Dogs have an exceptionally olfactory system, allowing them to sniff out the faintest of odors. This makes bone detection a breeze, even if it lies beneath layers of earth. Migaloo, in particular, took part in a 6-month-long training exercise, which included field trials and uncovering a 250-year-old remain from a native burial site. Migaloo also holds the world record for the oldest bone discovered by a dog after digging up a 600-year-old human bone buried more than 6 feet under the ground. The previous record was 425-year-old human bone set 25 years ago by a cadaver dog named Candy. Karen Walsh, an archaeology researcher at the SA Museum, said that Migaloo was able to find the first of 4 burial sites in under a minute.
Ooh.
She was spot on, said Walsh to news.com.au. Watch out, Harrison Ford, you got some competition!
Oh, man!
Oh, yeah!
I feel like this could be like...
Oh, yeah!
Because that's a good idea, having a dog is like an archaeological thing, because...
Yeah, it makes sense.
They use dogs for like everything else,
yeah,
okay?
Yeah, I mean, drugs,
yeah,
blind people, dead people. I mean, why not use them to find really old dead people?
Yeah.
Doesn't that make sense?
That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah. It does.
So, okay, we got about 5 minutes more of news, so we can just talk about this story. If we
about,
do another
about
one,
this story?
If you want. But, oh, okay, before we do this, we have to do a shout-out to Ethan, my brother, who is watching right now.
Ooh. Hi, Ethan! Ethan, I love you!
Love you!
Ethan, hi.
I don't know if we've met Ethan, but I don't know. I'm pretty sure we've met a couple of times.
Have you met Rachel, i.e. China Rose? Have you met Rachel, i.e. China Rose?
The ongoing
let's
joke.
Let's find one more interesting story.
One more, but we only got about 5 minutes.
Yeah, I know. We got plenty
of
time.
I want to do segments on movies and games that really...
Well, we can... Okay. We're going
to
close the show with story time.
Oh, God.
And,
Story
time, yes.
Because I'm a great storyteller.
Yeah. I feel like Mason has been waiting for this moment.
I wait for these.
We have to...
Ethan says he loves you all.
Ethan,
we love you
all. Shut up, Ethan. Shut up. You're my favorite.
We love you.
We love you.
Ethan, are we entertaining?
No.
Shoot us a text.
Just say no.
Spider-hunting wasp caught killing Australia's most dangerous spider.
Whoa.
Oh, wait, don't you be dumb.
Wasps are scary.
Wasps are scary, man. Like you know, man. Okay,
it's like the only reason they exist is
here's
to
deal.
Hurt people.
Spider in the shower, don't care. Go to your corner, I'll go to mine. We're all good. Mm-hmm. Wasps comes up to me, though, man. I am freaking out. Especially,
damn, wasp, you're scary. You're pulling a Trey McIntosh.
Especially if it's in my house. Like, if I'm sitting there... laying in bed, watching Dexter, because that's what I do, because I love Dexter. Watching Dexter, and all of a sudden I look up, and there's a freaking wasp. I go, well, Trey McIntosh. And I'm like, ah! You don't know who Trey McIntosh is, but...
You want to explain?
Trey
want me
McIntosh
to?
Is our one black friend.
He's the whitest black guy you'll ever meet.
He's the whitest man. He's the whitest guy, you know, Caucasian, black, Asian, Hispanic, I don't care. He's the whitest guy you'll ever meet. And there are people who talk with their hands very presidential-like, you know, very... But Trey McIntosh, he's just, I'm Trey McIntosh! His hand movements make no sense whatsoever, so we just make fun of him all the time. Anyway, back to the wasp story.
Wasps.
Tiny wasp, largely ignored by researchers for nearly 250 years, has been discovered to be a vicious hunter of Australia's most dangerous spider. The wasp, some Italian word, was first identified in 1775 after being collected during an expedition by famed explorer Captain James Cook. Since then, though, researchers have turned a blind eye to the small insect, believing it to be an ordinary bug. Boy, were they wrong. It turns out the wasp is a ninja-like predator of the red-backed spider. an arachnid related to the North America's black widow that is responsible for more than 250 life-threatening bites each year.
Ooh.
These wasps have been dragging away redback spider carcasses under the noses of researchers for over two centuries.
Now that's scary if they're doing under-the-nose researches.
Yeah.
It truly is a ninja.
It wasn't until a couple years ago that a 9-year-old boy first caught sight of one of these assassins in action. Assassin's Creed, I think you just found your next assassin. The curious young boy, Florian Irwin, a resident of Beaconsfield, Western Australia, immediately notified his father of what he saw. Blah, blah, blah. As it happens, the wasp doesn't actually hunt the spiders for food. Instead, it lays its eggs inside of the spider's paralyzed bodies, and after the larvae hatch, they slowly devour the deadly arachnids from the inside out.
Take that, spiders!
In other words, the spiders are actually destroyers for the wasp's offspring. This sounds like Alien.
It does. But okay, something else we need to mention. How would you like to be that 9-year-old boy that discovers this scary as heck wasp that is a ninja of the wasp world, of the insect world? Even more so than some spiders who are pretty scary.
Probably poop.
Yeah. I would be the guy that would run to my dad and say, "Hey Dad, I just saw the scariest thing I've ever seen in my life.
There was a giant wasp.
Catching deadly spiders. Carrying away
a giant spider."
Huh. That's a lot of fun.
What would you do if you found out that a wasp had laid eggs inside of you?
Well, I wouldn't enjoy it.
I just feel like I would cut off whatever limb it was in.
Why? I would be willing to remove a limb.
And then become like Vader.
Why?
Yes.
Did you know that Vader in German means father?
Really?
So the twist that Darth Vader was Luke's father actually should have been very, very foreseeable.
Huh. Well, you're, I mean, gross. Like Germans. Germans would know.
So his name was legitimately Darth Father.
That is a lot cool. Of echo.
Oh, wait, it's gone. The echo is gone.
I'm
pushing buttons.
Yeah.
He's playing.
isn't that kind of interesting? Like, how did we get on that? Oh, yeah, we were talking about how if you had a robot arm, you'd be like,
yeah.
All right. Yeah, anyway.
That would be really cool.
I have all sorts of random knowledge that makes no sense and is not important to life at all.
Kids, and this is why we have Hanske on this show.
Yes.
Meth is a hell of a drug. Don't do meth.
Hey,
meth,
you know what? Go fuck yourself.
Nah. Too much work.
So, it's be 6 o'clock. Do we want to move on to story time?
Is it story time?
Okay, guys. This is our segment that we like to call story time. And it doesn't necessarily have to do with furry stuff.
No.
Just... we'll kind of freestyle it, and anyone that says I have a story, they can say a story. And Hanske and I are going to tell, like, dual stories.
Dante, I have a story.
What is your story, Hanske?
All right. So, those of you who are furries who are also in the video game nerding world will know what I'm talking about here. So, Legend of Zelda, The Ocarina of Time.
Greatest game ever made.
Possibly the greatest game ever made. It's actually been voted the greatest game ever made.
By many, many times. Game critics.
Not just by Nintendo, but by many, many game critics. Even those Xbox-loving bastards.
Yes.
Anyway.
Because all the Xbox-loving bastards started with an N64.
Yes, exactly. Because N64 is the gateway drug to video gaming.
Exactly.
Moving on. So, I heard about this thing online called the Three Heart Challenge. And essentially... you go through The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time without picking up a heart.
Okay.
And so we had it for the GameCube and realized we didn't have a game card. A memory card, I'm sorry.
Wait, we gotta say that this was the week that we were really broke.
Yeah, we were like we were broke. Like,
and this was like right before Christmas break. We didn't have school, I didn't have work, et cetera, et cetera. So we were sitting here in my apartment, we had nothing to do, just kinda hanging out, and you know, Hanske is on his laptop, he's like, "Dude, let's do the Three Heart Challenge." I was like, "I think I know what that is just by the name." He's like, "Don't pick up a heart container. Do you think we can do it?" And I was like, "Heck yeah, we can do it."
Yeah.
So we were on a mission to get a memory card because, you know, with GameCube, we were not going to risk somebody turning it off and losing our saves, and we didn't have a memory card.
And his GameCube, if you even touch it, it does this reset thing, and I think
I did not want to risk that.
Stuff would have been thrown across the room. Someone might have died if I was, say, on the final boss.
And keep the knives away.
Bumped it, and then I had to start over from the beginning. It fit would have hit the shan. It just wouldn't have been good. So,
Anyways.
Go ahead.
Do you want me to tell the rest?
You,
or the
you,
next part?
Yeah,
next part.
You tell
okay.
The next part.
It's a tag team.
It is a tag team.
Okay, so we needed a memory card. Otherwise, we were going to flip shit.
Oh, yeah.
So we're calling everybody we know. By the way, this is Atumwa. We live in a town called Atumwa. So we're calling everybody in Atumwa that we know in eastern Iowa that we know at college. And nobody has a memory card. Anyone that does have a memory card is like gone for the weekend or something. And
I
we can't
find mine.
It's mine.
I'm sorry.
It's mine. So we call everybody we know. Nobody has a memory card. We even call people that we barely know. Nobody has a memory card. So we're like,
yes.
You know what? Pawn shops.
No,
GameStop. Please. GameStop. So we call GameStop. We're like, you guys have GameCube memory cards? They're like, no. So we're like, okay, well, what do we do now? This is at the point where we were contemplating just risking, you know, because we had to do this.
We were so bored.
We absolutely had to do this. So we're like, okay, we absolutely have to find a memory card or we're going to risk, you know, Tonsuke over here just doing something drastic that he would regret for the rest of his life.
I don't know if I'd regret it, but...
Okay.
I'm just going
to... Anyways, so I get the idea that we should look at a pawn shop because I've been to the pawn shops here in Atumwa and they have all kinds of old video game stuff.
All kinds
memory
of stuff.
Cards, cartridges, etc.
Everything.
And so we go driving around. And by the way, we're flat broke. You know, we're just like... We have no idea how we're going to get money. But we're going anyway. That's the beauty of it. We're like, we're going to find one. We might not be able to pay for it, but we'll find one.
I was ready to sell myself on the corner.
Yes. So we go around. There's all the pawn shops in Atumwa are kind of bunched together. So we're like, okay, we'll just park here and walk around the street. The one that I usually go to is closed. We're like, oh, crap. We look over across the street. There's one that's open. Okay, we go inside. We're like, hey, how late are you guys open? They said, what did they say, 5?
Well,
they
first,
said 4.
You missed a part of the story.
What did I miss?
So we go into this pawn shop, and I ask them, I say, hey, do you have any GameCube memory cards?
Asked them that first, and then
we asked them that first, and so he brings out this box, and all they have in there is frickin' PS2 memory cards.
And I started to get worried.
I was getting pissed. And so he's like, no, wait, let me go to the back, and let me check. And so he goes in the back, and lo and behold, he comes out with one game cartridge. Not
one
game cartridge, one single memory card.
The very last one he had.
The very last. And so I look at him and I say, hey, we don't have the money now. What time are you guys open till? And he says, 4 o'clock! 6 o'clock p.m. right now. And so I was like, in the morning? No, at night. So they were open 2 hours late.
Yes.
It was like fate.
By chance.
So we asked him, how much is this memory card going to cost? And he said, about $5.50. I had $2.
So you know how much it costs? How much did it cost?
How much did it cost? It costs about
tree fitty.
And no. If you don't know what tree fitty is,
it's a South Park reference.
It's $3.50. We need about tree fitty.
Best ever.
Tree fitty.
Best.
You want to keep going?
I will.
Okay, go for it.
So we needed to get our hands on tree fitty. Does it sound familiar?
I've heard the story many times.
We were like the Loch Ness Monster.
We're the Loch Ness Monster. So we go to an ATM, and Hanske has his card out. I have negative money on my account, so I'm not getting a dollar. I'm not getting a cent out of my account. So Hanske's like, I got some money on my card. So we go to the ATM. He has money on his card, but for some reason it's not accepting it. So we're really mad.
It's my luck.
And so we freak out, and we're starting to look around the car for stuff to sell. I'm even considering selling my lighter at this point, which I love, to get this memory card.
Yes.
It was so important to us. So we needed to get our hands on Tree Fitty. We couldn't do it in the ATM. So we call my sister, who was here at the apartment, and we say, hey, Haley, do you happen to have Tree Fitty on you?
Tree Fitty.
And, of course, at this point, we told her the story, and she gets the reference that she was laughing, you know, need Tree Fitty. Do you want to continue?
Yes. And then she asks, what do you need Tree Fitty for? And I tell her, I need Tree Fitty for a memory card. And over the phone, she tells me the saddest news I've ever heard. She says, I have a memory card right here. I was pissed.
So was I.
And she asks, do you want to just use my memory card? And I said, no. We've been searching for an hour and a half for Tree Fitty.
It was fate and destiny that we were to have this memory card.
We must get this card. So we come back and we scrounge around and find
Tree Fitty. And Avon, our friend Avon,
oh,
who's
right,
here,
that's right,
just Avon. Handed me $3. I'm like,
Ooh, that works.
$3.50.
So then we bolted out the door to the car. We race over there while still trying to be really, you know, cautious of the road. But we were bolting it over there. And we ran in there and they're like, took you guys a little while. We're like, yes, give us the memory card. Like,
and he gave it to us.
No bullcrap. We want this memory card right now.
Yes.
And they gave it to us. And we came back and we named our character Tree Fitty. True story.
True story.
And we're still working on that.
We're at the challenge. Final boss battle. Yeah.
We're at the final boss.
It's incredibly difficult.
Yep.
Anyway, anybody else got a story?
Story of the day. Anyone else got something?
No stories.
No stories.
And got shit.
Nothing. Liam, do we want to tell the story of how Liam slipped on pee again?
Yes. That's a great story.
You want to? Let's do a tag team again.
Okay. You want to start or you want me to start?
You can start.
Okay, I'll start. So, Liam, first of all, you need to understand, Liam's a big guy. He's wanting to be in the military. He wants to be a cop.
Indeed.
So, Liam comes to school, and he has a brace on his knee. And I look at Dante. I'm sorry, Dante. I didn't mean
to. We're still not used to this.
Reveal your secret identity.
Nobody cares.
Dante and me are sitting in Long John Silver's, and Liam walks away, and I ask, Dante, what happened to Liam's knee?
Well, Hanske, I will tell you.
All right.
He slipped on dog pee. And
dog pee?
Busted his knee.
Dog pee?
I know.
Goodness gracious.
Do you want to tell the whole story, Liam?
Well, fuck yourselves.
Oh. I'm sorry. This is too funny.
Oh, for those watching, watch this.
Thank you.
Parental discretion.
Kids don't copy anything.
Enough of the fingers, okay? This is a kid-friendly show.
Birds don't need to be kid-friendly. These birds. I'm scared.
Claws and Convo, the show that tries to be kid-friendly but fails. Part of a complete breakfast.
I do have a story, but it's from my childhood. Do you want to hear it?
I would like to hear the story from your childhood.
It is furry kind of related.
Ooh!
Doesn't matter.
Okay, it is actually furry related.
That's good.
So, when I was younger,
She was just a wee little panda.
I used to think eggs that were in the cartons could be made into chickens. And I real badly wanted a little chick in my house so I can snuggle it and play with it and all that.
Haven't we all had that phase?
Yes, we've all actually thought of that.
Oh, okay. I thought you meant wanted a chick
in your
house.
Okay, except for Hanske because he's too cool for that.
So, like, I took it, and I had, like, this bed pose that kind of had, like, this little secret compartment where you could hide stuff in it. So I took, like, my blankets and my special blanket, which was named Uh-Oh. Okay, that's another story for another time. But I took it and wrapped it in there, and I put it, and I left it there for, like, 2 weeks, and one day Mom was cleaning my room and found it and got real pissed off. She's like, what in the hell? And I go, I wanted a chick. And she's like, you, these eggs are dead. And I'm like, oh. That's my dreams were crushed as
perfectly timed.
Liam.
Yeah, fuera.
We told you to silence your phone.
Smash it.
I don't have a story, but I have a question for all of you because we were talking about things that we did when we were little kids.
Please continue.
Did any of you ever think that brown cows were what chocolate milk came from?
I actually did not think
Another
that.
Story. Can I tell you a story about brown cows?
Please
sure.
do.
So,
powered up. Brown chicken, brown cows.
Brown chicken, brown cows. About a couple years ago, I was a wrestling manager, and one of our little black kids was like, legitimately just looked at me, straight-faced everything. Like, I'm pretty sure he's just that dumb. He's like, he looked at me and he goes, does chocolate milk come from brown cows? And I looked at him and I was like, does cherry milk or strawberry milk come from pink cows?
I thought that too.
He just looked at me, and he's a freshman in high school. Like, you should know better.
I didn't. Well, that's a little bit
pathetic. Like, you should know better.
If he was like a 6-year-old kid, that would have been.
That's what I thought. It.
Yeah.
Like, I almost beat him.
Oh.
So when I was a little kid, I had a little chicken. It's like, what are they called? The smaller chickens? Do you know what that breed is called?
Yeah.
It's a different breed.
Rhode
it's
Island like, chicken?
It's a different breed of chicken that's tiny, meant to, that's like really small. They're really, really small.
Chicken.
They're like that tall. They're really small. And we used to have one living in our closet. Her name was Tilly.
Wait, there was like, you had one living in your closet?
We had one when I was younger.
Wait.
I'm not kidding you.
Did it ever come out of the closet?
Oh! Gay chicken joke. But
what came first, the chicken or the egg? In that case, no one knows.
Yeah.
Did it choke the chicken?
Oh!
So, anyway. Point being, I actually
disgusting.
I legitimately had a pet chicken that laid eggs for us. Farm fresh eggs. In the mornings.
In the closet?
In the morning.
Fresh eggs are the best.
They are.
Man, store-bought eggs ain't got crap on farm fresh eggs. Continue.
So, yeah, that's pretty much what
that's
it is.
It.
That's
we
the story.
We had a chicken living in our closet.
Damn, that came through loud.
Kenny, turn off your phone!
He has the Dukes of Hazzard horn. It's so loud.
So turn it on to... Turn it,
people don't want to hear
turn
it
on to silent. Turn it on silent.
Just turn the volume down. Okay, it's not that hard.
You know, I mean, first he slips on pee. Now he's... Now he thinks he rules the place, man.
As head producer of this production, I certainly apologize for this...
whatever he is.
You mother bitch! Burn him!
We were just in the comic book store, like, what was it, 2 hours ago?
Something like that.
It was around 2 o'clock.
Yes, we are nerds. Is
we have to tell the story.
Wrong with that?
Okay, after this, I'm telling the story of my first visit to the comic book store.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways, we're in the comic book store, and the phone goes off, and it echoes through the whole store.
That's
Here, I'll make it easy.
No, if it was something cool, kind of like...
Stop it!
I'm gonna pee on the floor and
make
you trip
on
it so your other leg is broken, and then while you're in on the floor crying in agony, I'm gonna steal your phone.
Like, if you're in a comic book store, it would be cooler if, like, the Mortal Kombat theme came on or something, but no.
Mortal
I couldn't
Kombat.
Find it!
Like, that'd be badass. Like, I'd be like, yeah, but then,
round
no, that's
one.
Lame.
Fight!
Yeah, exactly.
Get over here!
Get over here!
Finish him!
Fatality!
Finish him!
Fatality!
That's our rendition of Mortal Kombat.
Enough with the annoying Mortal Kombat references.
Mortal Kombat.
I guess I can't. I don't have any room to speak because I was doing it too.
Anyway.
So I'm going to tell a very quick story about my first visit to the comic book store. It's a really short story, don't worry. So Hansuke is all like, hey, dude, let's go to the comic book store.
To clear things up, I've been a comic book nerd since I was old enough to read, and my father has around 12,000 comic books in his basement.
Yeesh.
So I like comic books.
And I like graphic novels. I like furry comics. I'm huge in furry comics. I'm like a big Better Days, Jay Naylor. Whoa. Big Better Days, Jay Naylor fan, et cetera, et cetera.
Don't take it down.
Yeah, I have a frame. My favorite picture from Better Days is framed. That's how much of a... Okay, just basically exclusive to furry comics is I'm a nerd about that.
America.
So anyways, I'm like, okay, you know, that'd be kind of fun to go to a comic book store because Hansuke is all like, we need to do it. And the guy that runs this starts it at noon because he's lazy and, you know...
And if you own a comic book store, I mean, why not?
Yeah, because all the people that go
because
are people that sleep
because nerds
aren't
going to wake
in.
Up until noon.
Exactly. So anyways, he's like, let's go to the comic book store. I'm like,
really?
Okay, cool. He drove me over there. We walked in, and this was my reaction. Oh, this is kind of... Oh, my word! This is amazing! Like, why have I never been here before? Even if you're not a straight-up comic book nerd, it's still really cool. Like,
that was my... how I felt when I first walked into Guitar Center.
Yeah, exactly the same reason. Like, the same concept. You walk in, you're like... It's absolutely beautiful.
Did you guys want Mortal Kombat sounds?
No, go away.
No.
Go away!
No.
Go away. We don't want
not
them!
Not
I just got every single one.
We did our fair share of Mortal Kombat sound effects. And
I will destroy you!
Yeah, exactly. And I don't think anyone wants to hear anymore.
No more sound effects on the phone. Right. If we're going to do sound effects, me and Austin can make them ourselves.
Yes.
You're not the guy from Cop.
And you're not... I don't know.
Oh.
Okay.
And you slipped in pee.
You slipped in pee.
Not me.
Somebody shoot
me. Let's make
me.
A poem about Liam Wolf slipping
we
in pee.
Next week,
who
we'll
slipped
be a
in
poem
pee?
About
not me. It is Liam Wolf. Okay, well, help me out here.
Let's I don't know.
I can make poems, but I'm not going to
we're next time, we'll try to have a poem about Liam Wolf slipping and pee.
Either that or I'll make a picture book.
Yes.
We should read.
Go
the fuck to sleep.
Do you want to?
We should.
Well, it's kind of long.
So it would be funny.
We do have... Okay, what time?
Not right now, but like next week. What time are we done?
Around 6:30. But we can do it. Okay.
Yeah.
Here's the reason is because we know a lot of you like to watch Friday Night Tech, and it goes on at 7. So we're going to attempt to wrap it up before 7 o'clock, but that remains to be seen.
Yes. Yes.
Yeesh.
Anyway.
So does anyone else have any more stories?
Well, I have lots of stories.
Yeesh. But are they interesting?
Are they interesting stories? I have some short, funny stories.
I like short, funny stories.
Okay.
Tell us one.
All right. So my grandfather, right? He's awesome. Or he passed away recently. But anyway, moving on from that. He was a cigarette smoker. And I rode on the plane with him. And when I get on the plane, he says, Mason, there better not be any layovers. And I say, why? And he says, because I need my cigarettes. And so, riding to New York, fine. Riding back, not fine. We get to Chicago, and we actually get into the airport. We're like landing things, and we hear a thing from the stewardess. You are not going to be able to get at the gate for 45 minutes. So we're sitting in a plane, and my cigarette-smoking grandfather is starting to lose a little bit. And one of his phrases is, well, I'll be damned. So out of nowhere, I'm napping, and I just hear, well, I'll be damned. And I'm like, what? And he's like, I just can't do this. And so I'm not really paying attention to him. And I look over, and he's pulled out his box of cigarettes and is snorting the cigarette. And it was the funniest thing I've ever seen. It was great. So
your grandpa is amazing.
He was a cool guy. He taught me to drink black coffee.
Like a man.
He taught me how to smoke a pipe. Although I kind of tricked him into teaching me how to smoke a pipe, I told him it was because I needed to for a play, which wasn't completely untrue, but yeah.
Because you had to do it for a play, but then
I did.
Then Hanske and I developed a habit of our thing.
It's
not a habit. Okay. Our thing is smoking pipes.
Yes.
Why at the beginning of the show we showed these awesome freaking pipes that we just bought.
We picked up today, by the way, at an antique shop.
Right next to the comic book store, which I just previously talked about.
Yes. Yes.
Anyways,
I hope you clean that.
Yes, that's my story. It was great.
Somebody's got to have a story besides us two.
Come on.
You look at me.
I've got tons.
Yeah.
Of
what do you want me to tell you?
You have good stories.
What do you want?
I
don't know.
I don't care.
You want childhood stories? No.
Tell us something interesting. Funny.
What's funny?
Entertain us, China.
Hooker stories?
Hooker stories.
So one time, you know, I was on the street corner and this guy. No, real story.
Okay.
So you know that coat I have, the one that kind of makes me look like a drug dealer?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's like a big overcoat.
It's really cool.
Yeah.
Or kind of like a spy thing. Well, I'm standing outside Walmart, and this black guy, like, rolls up. Like, I'm just standing outside smoking a cigarette, and this, like, guy in a car, and he was a black guy, and a colored guy, whatevs. And, or it could have been any guy. I don't know, but he's colored, okay? Okay, so I don't want to be mean. And he rolls up, and he's like, you holding? I kind of look at him, and I go, no. And he's like, oh, okay. And I'm like, okay. Like, I didn't know what else to say. Okay. And he just drove away. And I'm like,
this
really?
Is a tumble, ladies and gentlemen.
I have a real funny story.
Okay.
Please tell us.
It's also related to drugs.
Oh. So many drug stories.
So, my little brother is diabetic, type 1. Yeah, my family has some health issues where most of us are okay except for him.
Yeah.
He's diabetic. He has type 1 diabetes, which means his pancreas doesn't work right. He doesn't get the right amount of insulin, blah, blah, blah. So he has pens that have insulin in it that he has to give himself shots with so that he doesn't die. So we're at the mall in Iowa City, and we're out in the car. We're going to go in and eat, and he says, I'm just going to do my insulin shot now. And so he pulls it out and is doing his thing, and I'm out there helping him. And all of a sudden, this guy who looks like freaking crazy comes and starts knocking on the window. And Connor,
I think I've heard this one.
Connor rolls down his window just a crack and says, yeah, what do you want? And this guy's like, dude, I need some bad. And my brother's like, what do you mean? He's like, some of that stuff, whatever you're shooting in your arm. And my brother's like, this is insulin. This will kill you. And like the guy is like just adamant on buying this insulin, thinking it's heroin.
And my brother's like, this will kill you. He's like, I don't care, man. I don't care. I want it. It was one of the funniest things ever. And my brother just rolls up the window and just like drives off. It was awesome. It was pretty funny.
It's terrible. So. That's great.
That's great.
Yes.
Great in a terrible way.
Yes. Drugs are bad, okay?
You got
drugs
what? Are bad.
Did I ever tell you about the time I got bucked by a cow?
You got bucked by a cow.
Okay.
What were you doing riding a cow? Oh,
no, I wasn't riding rodeo. It. Okay, no, I wasn't even at a rodeo. I was bottle feeding this calf, and you know how you have to get it up so it eat? Like, yeah. You have to get it to stand. So I straddle it, and as soon as I straddle it, it stands up.
Straddling a calf. Sexy.
Wrong choice of words.
How else am I going to put it? I put my leg over the cow. Like, you want to die?
Let's get it on.
whoa, you're gonna knock this stuff over.
Okay, so yeah, so I did that, and like she stood up, and her name was Drooly because she drooled a lot. She did. Every time she ate, she drooled. Okay, so I'm trying, and I have the bottle in my hand, and I'm trying to get her up, and I'm like, come on, and I get over it, and she like stands up and starts bucking me. I jump off of her, and I can't jump back over the fence because parts were hurting. That's my story. I am.
Well, I got one that you can tell. Okay.
What am I telling?
You got. Okay. You need to tell the story of how I got you into the furry fandom.
Oh my God. Okay.
So we need to talk about how we're all in like the acting thing. Do you want to talk about that?
Yeah. So we're in acting class together.
Yeah.
All like.
Four
us
of us.
Four.
This guy over here is from Centerville though. He
close
hangs out with us all the time. So close enough.
Close enough, all the same. And first time I really talked to Dante, we were...
Get it right.
We were sitting in the lunchroom, I think. Was it the lunchroom or were we just talking?
No, it was when we were like...
Are we doing practice
groups? I remember specifically. Okay, we were watching people and critiquing their monologues. And
yeah.
I turned around to you and I said, do you know... Just I randomly ask people if they know what a furry is.
Yeah.
Just because I want to see... Like, I'm really, really open about it. And I know a lot of people get, you know, like, including my brother who's watching, gets really annoyed about it.
Yeah.
But it's so much fun. Okay, I love to see what people say about it. So I will randomly ask people, do you know what a furry is? You know? And Rachel, first time I met her, she would tell him, she made meme references, and I immediately liked her.
Yeah, internet things.
So.
Nerd things. Whatever.
So I wondered if she knew what a furry was, and she said yes. Do you want to tell us? Do you want... So would you like to tell us what you said when I said you were a furry?
Don't! You sandbagging some bitch. Okay, so... God damn. Okay, so... He turned around and asked me. He's like, so, do you know what a furry is? And
Mine's longer than yours.
The only
Shut
thing...
Shut up!
The only said. Thing... It doesn't matter about length. It's the motion of the ocean. But,
Mine has a nicer shape than yours.
So,
okay, just stop interrupting her.
Let me tell my story.
Shut up!
Let you tell your story.
Listen to Stryker.
You're fired.
You're fired.
I'm not getting paid for this.
Oh, yeah.
I will pay you, then duck your pay.
I'll pay you and then take it away.
Okay. Okay. Get nothing.
So he turns around and he goes, do you know what a furry is? And I go, and the only thing I'd known from furryism or whatever, I was like, from South Park and watching like TV, and I was like, oh, you're one of those people. Like,
she mentioned the word orgies.
And I did. I was like, you have orgies. And he's like, no, God, no. I'm like, oh, okay. So like he explained it to me, and I'm like, oh, and like it clicked in my head. I was like, I might possibly be a furry. And he's like, oh, and I'm like, yeah. You want coffee now?
All right. Give me some more coffee.
Hey, me too.
Please. Yes, okay. Thank you. She's a good one.
I have a couple.
One is not simply hawk in the Mordor.
It's a picture.
That's my bird.
It's a picture of a hawk going like this, and it says, one does not simply hawk into Mordor.
I have a couple, but one isn't fur related, but the other one relates to
Mordor. As long as it's an interesting story, I'll be
okay. Fine. So the first one is, one day, we were falling behind. This is when I worked in lawn care. We were falling behind, so me and my grandma, we decided to go out and get the job done. Well, we were using the old mower, we were spraying old grass, and I drive over this dry
grass seed, not knowing it. And next thing I know, all I see is smoke flying off the tractor, and I'm like, what the heck? And I look down, and my entire mower is on fire right underneath me. And the worst part is there's a gas tank right next to my foot, a full gas tank, and I immediately hurl myself off the mower, literally put my foot up against it and kick it down the hill. And these are the words
that's
from
what
my,
I would do.
And these are the words from my grandma's mouth. Good, now that you got rid of it, go get it. So I sprint down, rip my jacket off, and start putting
coffee,
out the fire.
Coffee.
And luckily nothing happened, so we were able to take care of it.
We're coffee addicts.
And then
we are.
The second story I've got is I own a purebred Great Dane at my house.
Is this the one that peed on you?
No. That was...
No,
that
he
was
said, he said it earlier. It was the puppy that he brought.
Yeah, this
he
is a
back.
New puppy. Okay. And I've had this dog for years, and mine is a rare breed of Great Dane. Rare blue eyes, rare coat color, and he loves to wrestle around. So we're wrestling around one day, and I just keep I'm just pushing him, you know, back, and he gets ticked at me, and I'm not kidding you, ladies and gentlemen. Picks up his paw and punches me square in the face, knocks me out, punches me so hard.
Nice. Show that to the camera.
Chewbacca's baby.
Get it. Show it to the camera. Can we see it? Can we see it?
We need to find a way to connect things.
Yeah.
Chewbacca's baby.
We can do that. We
that's
just
acceptable.
Have to set things up.
Here, let me see
on
that.
New stream.
We can do that next time.
Yeah.
Not
yeah.
a big deal.
Oh crap! That's my dog.
Anyway, any other funny stories?
I got peed
I'm
on.
I'm trying
by
to
dog.
Think.
You got peed on by a dog? How does that make you
I got my nose
no.
bitten by a turtle.
Oh my god, okay. So, we're cracking nuts outside, and I have me and my cousins. Shut up. So.
We're so immature.
Oh my god.
It's called a butt shelf.
But I just am too.
So, my little cousin, who's like 10, okay. You're not even paying attention.
I'm paying attention.
You put the iPod down.
My little
Get
cousin.
The iPod here.
My little cousin's like 10, and she's like sitting there. And we have a dog named Boba, you know, like Boba Fett, and he's a little shit. And he just lifted his leg and peed on her. And she, real calm, looks at me and goes, "I think your dog peed on me." And I look behind her, and clearly enough, there's a wet spot on her back. And I just kind of looked at her, and I was like, "Come with me, I'll go help you change your shirt. I'll give you one of my shirts." And she's like, "Okay." And I felt so bad for her, but like, it was so cute because she was just so calm. Like, you think little girls, oh my god. No,
okay.
She was like,
"I got peed
I just
on
got peed on.
It's like Fluttershy.
Yay. She's not at all like Fluttershy. All
right, so I have one more funny story.
Okay.
That's not furry related at all.
Anyway, acceptable.
Yes, it's acceptable. Okay, so I'm a big guy. Just going to throw it out there.
Nope.
I'm kind of fat.
I don't know it.
I'm kind of fat. I like cookies. A lot.
He does.
I really like cookies.
A lot.
A lot. So there's work. Something on your floor, bro. So anyway.
What?
I don't know. It's wet and it's bothering me. Kenny, did you pee on the floor?
Ayo.
Anyway.
So he can slip in.
Anyway, so I really like cookies, right? So I'm in my aunt and uncle's house and my aunt makes cookies because she knows I really like cookies.
Yeah.
Yeesh.
And so... I'm eating cookies, enjoying life, and I decide I'm tired, so I'm going to go to bed. So I went to bed, and when I woke up the next morning, I'm eating cookies again for breakfast, and my uncle looks at me, and he's eating cookies too, because he likes cookies too, it's a family thing, and he looks at me and starts laughing, and I don't know why, and he points to my armpit, and there is chocolate chip. Melted chocolate chips all on here. There's melted chocolate chips on my back. There's melted chocolate chips everywhere. I had gotten up in the middle of the night without knowing it. I was sleepwalking. Went and got the box of cookies. Took them to my bed. And ate cookies all night.
That's acceptable.
That's something you would do.
It's something I would do. I know that's not the funniest story in the world, but... It's
you know,
great.
It's pretty fun.
You know what woke and me up one night? Mason yelling, "Get off me, you Satanist bitch."
What the heck?
I don't remember this.
You were dead, Austin. It was great.
I
didn't say anything, but you were dead.
Was this like when we, New Year's Eve?
Yeah.
Oh,
just everyone was
New
dead.
Year's Eve. I'm not going to tell the story.
We're out of time.
Good.
We are out of time.
Well,
can I give some words of wisdom? Just
what did we learn today?
What did
we okay, here's the last segment. What did we learn on the show today?
Well, do you want to say the last segment? The words of wisdom is the last thing that I want to do.
We'll do words of wisdom first. Do it.
Okay, words of wisdom. It's from my grandfather. He told me, every day is better than the last. Sometimes you just have to look harder for it. Boom!
Boom!
There you go. There's the intelligent words of wisdom for the day.
Oh, yeesh. I suppose I got one. Yes, this is related to my injury. You can all shut the hell up.
We're going to make fun of you anyway.
Don't slip on dog pee?
Don't. No. The injury to my knee has caused me to not be able to work out and do anything for military and law enforcement. But I want you everybody to know, no matter what happens to you, always keep that dream up. Always focus. Don't give up. I still focus on everything. I still take my classes. I still focus, and I always work it out. So never stop.
That's true. Kenny will – I'm sorry, Liam Wolf will go with me walking around Walmart even though he's not supposed to be on his knee, and he will go just to help me out with stuff. Like, it really – I really appreciate that he does this kind of thing. He's a good friend.
And now I've been told if I keep walking on it, I'm screwed.
No. Don't.
No, I'm just saying. I'm not supposed to be doing this.
I mean, I'm saying you. I don't think you should walk on it. But what I mean is that you take risks for me because of this, and you're not letting the knee bother you, and it makes me very
happy.
You
two, both hands on the table.
I'm not doing nothing.
Hands on the table.
No.
Yes.
Hands where we can see him.
Put them where we can. Thank you. Sorry, they're playing with each other.
No.
Kenny,
don't slip on some pee.
Goodbye, everybody. Thank you for watching.
We can't leave yet.
We just did.
All right, what did we learn today?
This is a segment called "What Did We Learn on Claws and Convo Today?"
Well, you know what I learned.
What is it, Hanske?
I learned that you should turn on a light when you walk out your room, yes, so you don't trip on dog pee.
Which app is it?
I did not see that one coming.
I learned that today.
You learned it.
What did you learn today, Dante?
I learned that a couple friends can make a successful podcast if they put their minds to it.
If we are successful.
That is true.
I hope we are.
Yes. Friends, you say.
I hope we were entertaining.
Did you learn anything, China Rose?
I learned. Did.
Did you done did learn?
I done did learn. I'm a good woman. Done did learn.
You are a good woman. She's a very good woman.
She actually makes really good sandwiches, too. It's wonderful.
Yeesh.
All right. Liam, what did you learn today? Did you learn not to trip on pee?
I learned you were an ass.
You just now learned this.
You just now figured this
actually,
out.
Actually, no, I knew it for a long time, but I just wanted everybody to have that. I don't want people to think bad. I love Mason. I've known him for 2 years now. He's a great guy.
We just like to pick on each other. It's what we do.
Yeah.
We've done it for years. Can we tell them what happened? The first day they showed up and we wrestled in the theater.
That was hilarious.
So we have to do this acting thing. And Mason, I get on and it's freeze. And I get on and I start doing one, two. And we start wrestling in the auditorium with the new freshman watching. Scared.
Scared.
I was like, what the heck is going on?
Yeah, we're real.
I was actually like, what the heck?
And me and Mason are both thinking this. We're thinking, oh my god, this is messing with them so bad.
Yeah, it was fun. It was fun.
It was fun.
It was fun.
All right, so Stryker, did you learn anything?
Well, I learned that this is evidence right here that furries are freaking everywhere.
Yes.
Yes.
And we control the world.
Yes.
We will someday. That's the lesson of the day, is furries will control the world someday.
Today, the internet. Tomorrow the world.
Yes. Indeed. So thank you all for watching. I hope you tune in next week at 5 p.m. Central Time. I forgot to mention that whenever I advertise the show. 5 p.m. Central Time on this Ustream channel. Hope you all enjoyed.
Peace out.
Catch you later.
Stay classy, San Diego.
Oh, yeah, that's rude.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Hello.